Pi, Pi, P-I, has been considered to be 3.14159... since approximately 300 BC, they gradually increased using hexagons and then eventually calculus to determine pi out to zillions of, you know, decimal points. But there's the philosophical, the theoretical, and the practical. And if you look on the internet, there is no practical experiment that proves that pi, that particular value of pi is correct. So what I'm going to suggest is that the ancients were right and we are wrong, and I'll show you why. If you reverse engineer using reverse psychology, you take the circle first, as shown on the screen, and we're going to say that that circle is 22 inches in diameter, or excuse me, 22 inches in circumference. We're not going to try to find circumference through diameter. We're going to try to find diameter through circumference. If the circumference is 22 inches, it follows logically that if the circle is divided into seven parts, seven equal parts, each part is 22 divided by 7, or what you see on the screen, 3.142857 inches, 3 1/7 inches. That's a no-brainer. 1/7 of the circle has to be that. That is locked. And it also follows that 7 times that amount, 7 times the amount of one section equals one full rotation of the diameter. So if you had the diameter starting as shown with the blue line and it rotated 1/7 of a rotation as shown, it would have covered, it would have turned a distance of 22 over 7 inches. And when it made a full rotation, as shown, it would have covered the full 22 inches. So we know that 22 inches divided into 7 parts equals a certain amount as shown. And we know for a fact that 7/7 of a rotation of the diameter gives 22 inches. It follows that the diameter has to be 7 inches. Now if you were to use traditional pi, if you were to take the 22 inches divided by pi and multiply it by 7 to get the 7/7 of the rotation, you would end up with an amount that would be 22.00885498 blah blah blah. In other words, too large to fit in a 22-inch circumference. Now, it may just seem convenient that 22/7 works out this way, but let's upscale it. Let's go to a circle divided into 8 parts that has a diameter of 8 inches. So we've upscaled it. The circumference is upscaled, as you can see. And still, you end up with one section and pi being 22/7. So one of the things that you can extrapolate from all this is that when the diameter and the number of divisions are the same, one section is always pi units. And pi has to be 22/7. It cannot be the traditional pi, because it, as you'll see in this diagram, it is definitely about rotation. And you, if you consider a wheel rotating, a full rotation will give you the circumference. And as in this diagram, or this GIF, if we consider that that circle is 22 inches and each section of that circle divided into seven parts is 22 over 7 inches, the only number that satisfies the diameter is 7 inches. If you use traditional pi, you get too big of a number for the diameter, and it will go beyond the 22 inches. I hope you enjoyed this video, and have a nice day.